When you start out in strategy, you are always trying to look for the competitive advantage for your brand. We focus on the strengths. However, the best work often lies when we research into your weaknesses. The 2021 Cannes Lions Grand Prix winners show us that great advertising can come from reframing your weaknesses. We'll look at three winners in Cheetos, Desiel, and Burger King, all brands which leaned into the negatives in the category, product, and execution. Firstly, let's talk about the science of the reframe. The reason reframes work is that they address two things. They capture our attention. Most advertising is wallpaper. It's expected and we predict what is going to be said before it happens. When a brand comes out and owns a weakness, it stops people and really makes you think about the brand. The second benefit is related to the associative network theory. It suggests that advertising works by strengthening the associations between the product and different themes. With reframing a weakness, we are creating new associations between what people would see as the weakness and a positive attribute. If you're interested in learning how to reframe, there are two great lessons in the Planning Dirty Academy on the subject. But now let's get into the three Grand Prix winners to show how these brands leaned into their negatives and won big. To begin with, we will look at Cheetos, who leaned into a negative attribute about the product. For Cheetos, one of the downsides of the product is that when you eat Cheetos, you're left with this Cheetos dust all on your fingers. It's really a messy snack. However, Cheetos reframed this to show it's the perfect solution for the hustle hard culture that was a problem for people today. People's snack time was under threat. Cheetos dust became the perfect alibi to doing nothing. Let's watch the ad quickly.
Cheetos has popcorn now?
Hey, I'm gonna need you to... Never mind.
You can't touch this.
Help!
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
I trust you.
Stop! Hammer time!
I touched it! New Cheetos popcorn. It's a Cheetos thing.
The next example is how you can lean into a negative trend in the category. For Desiel, a big consumer problem that the fashion industry was facing was wardrobing. People wearing clothes for a night and then returning them. However, instead of trying to tell people off, Desiel has always been a brand that has celebrated that rebellious side. So they embraced wardrobing and made it a central part of the campaign. Let's watch the case study.
Have you heard of wardrobing?
A lot of people do that. They wear something once and then they return it.
This is a type of shopping fraud that one in five of us are guilty of committing.
Apparently it's a big problem. Retailers say that it costs them $15 billion a year.
It's highly immoral in my opinion.
Items acquired can be returned. With all tags still attached and in their original packaging. All products offer bearing an identification label and must be tried on without removing the tag. So in case of buying, wearing, and returning clothes, remember to enjoy before returning.
There are certain rules that categories of advertising adhere to. You always show a car going on a windy road. Beer ads are always shown with groups of friends clinking glasses. There's a reason that these tropes exist, because they work. So breaking them can often be seen as a negative for a brand. For Burger King, that's exactly what they did with Moldy Whopper. Fast food advertising often communicates with food porn shots of burgers. These ads get hungry customers into restaurants. However, a lot of consumers know that these ads are fake and also that fast food is not real food. So when Burger King came out with no preservatives in their burger, deciding to show a moldy burger was definitely seen as a negative, but it had a clear reason for being. Let's watch the case study.
Fast food, an industry that offers convenient, craveable food at a good value. But
You put out a big pack and you could keep it there forever, right?
Right here.
No fungus, no mold, no smell.
Why is there no mold on that?
Well, because of all the stuff we put in our food.
What we put in our bodies.
It's time to change that.
What a difference a day made.
Burger King is rethinking the image of its signature Whopper burger.
They're turning a lot of heads with a new ad, and maybe some stomachs too.
Showing that mold can be a beautiful thing.
It shows a moldy Whopper as a way to announce that the fast food chain will no longer put preservatives in their food.
The beauty
of no artificial preservatives.
I think it's great. It's very risky, but I think it's a really neat commercial.
It's fascinating and gross at the same time. When I watch this, I'm like, I can't unsee this, but also I can't stop watching it.
When one company makes a decision like this, it certainly have ripples effects across the whole industry.
So is this really the best way to sell a burger?
Well, I know the difference in you.
Look, they're taking out preservatives. This is the real deal.
I think it really speaks to the fact that companies are hearing this huge tectonic shift of customers asking real questions about what's in their food.
They're removing preservatives because they feel real food tastes better.
The difference is you.
I'd love to hear if you have any other examples of where a brand has leaned into that negative side.